you know, we keep talking about MS Dhoni, the captain. I think it's about time we gave equal time and weightage to Rohit Sharma, the captain. Rohit Sharma's lifted trophies. Rohit Sharma, Lisa, has had the better of MS Dhoni and CSK a number of times. He's changed the fortunes of Mumbai Indians ever since he took over as captain. And I mean, he's a guy who's lifted three trophies.
Yeah.
You know. But MS has lifted three trophies. Yet we talk about MS as, best thing since sliced bread. And somehow he doesn't, you know, Rohit Sharma doesn't sort of match up to that. But by track record, he matches up to it.
He does. And what I've enjoyed the most is him managing the players. He's got a big group of players, a lot of egos as well within that. He's got the owners that are heavily involved.
Yeah.
He's got some star coaches. So he's got to manage that. But what I like about him is he's tactically sound.
Yeah.
Like, I like seeing how he tries to manipulate the game. T20 cricket, you can kind of go through a formula. You could go, right, they're going to go hard in the first six, let's just cope. Then let's try and squeeze, and then let's just cope again. But he tries to change things up throughout, and I like that. And that's why he's been so successful. And he should be spoken about as one of the best captains within the Indian side.
There's this great story, you know, book called The Reluctant Prime Minister, about one of our Indian prime ministers. He was a reluctant captain. In 2013, the point was that Ricky Ponting couldn't get into that side. They loved Ricky Ponting as a captain, but he couldn't fit into that 11 because it was probably, in my opinion, the strongest 11 ever in IPL history.
Yeah.
So that's how Rohit became captain. But she's exactly right. It's about managing different people. And there are so many stakeholders in Mumbai, the number of coaches, the owners. They are, you know, they are a substantial, you know, influence on this team. And they have large squads with lots of star players. So managing them is one part of it. The other part of it is somehow he's now found a way within that. So this year, how did Rohit set it up? For last year, we've been shouting, Rohit should open, Rohit should open. You know, we had this, please let Rohit open. This year, quietly in a press conference, he says, oh, it's been decided that I will open.
Yeah.
Now, what's happened is after that, whether they decide or not, it's very difficult for the management, everyone to go back on it. So now he knows how to work this system to his advantage as well, if you know what
Just
I
speak
mean.
First. Speak first, speak loudest, and reach the most number of people before anyone can tell you anything. And of course, tactically as well, we've noticed that T20 cricket, tactically, you got to be able to turn on a dime, right? You really have to.
Absolutely.
It can't happen from a dugout. It's got to happen there. Notice Rohit again and again sort of tends to get that. He tends to get the biorhythm of the game.
Yeah, he's got a good feel, a good gut, and he doesn't second guess himself. If you start second guess yourself, then the ball goes there and you've gone, I should have put a fielder there. And you start following the ball. So I think the fact that you can do as much research as you want in T20 cricket and do all your sports analysis and you'll know roughly where the players are going to hit and all that type of thing. But once you walk on the field, the best captains are the ones that are able to change like that.
Yeah.
They see the pitch, they see the opposition, they see the pickup, they see all of these things before they're played out, and they're able to be one step ahead. Now, that is an absolute skill that you cannot teach.
Yeah, you can't. And listen, that skill has actually got him to get the better of MS Dhoni, who we have no, you know, there's, we know his skills. But ever since he's taken over, which are the highlighted ones, you see he's got the better of him in playoff games.
Absolutely. From 13 onwards, if you look at it, they've basically...
He's got his number!
Absolutely. 4 out of 5 from this thing. And it's just, I think he plays him straight up. And it's very interesting. They'll, even in the, you know, toss, they'll talk beforehand. He was speaking to Dhoni, then he separated again just before. So to give him, there's so many mind games that happen out there, it's not surprising because MS is a very, very charismatic and a very difficult, you know, figure to match up to. So I love the way Rohit has managed it. And see, the other thing is he uses his resources well. So now whatever he's doing, say for example, Zaheer, our man in the studio for the longest time, he's his man for, so if Rohit needs something, he knows that Zaheer will be able to solve his problem for him, you know, across the cricket operation. So he's managed to find ways within this very tough structure, because see, this structure has its pluses. You have all the resources in the world at your disposal, all the stars. The problem is about making sure that this structure works for you.
Yeah.
It's not easy at the best of times. And Mumbai has suffered from it from 2008 to 2009, 10, 11, 12. He's found a way. He's unlocked that key. And that's really important. And the good thing is, if he was an egoistic person, he wouldn't have lasted.
Yeah.
You can make out he's relaxed, he's chilled. He knows what he's all about. And that's very important, you know.
Rohit, I'll tell you, he's like this. That can unlock most doors in Mumbai. You just go, like. You see the captain cam when it focuses on him. You think he's frazzled. He's not. That's just him. That's just how he expresses himself. I school inside for sure.